Hey Mod Runners, so here we are at Fontes and Phillips, which is my most favorite winery here in Santa Barbara County in the San Ynez Valley. I have with me the owner and the winemaker, Alan Phillips. Thank you for
my pleasure.
Absolutely being here. This is exciting. Yeah. One of the biggest things that I love about their wine is their Pinot Noir. And their 07 La Encantada is my most favorite wine of all time. Unfortunately, I've bought all of the 07. So what I have today is I have their 2010, which is very similar to the 07. It's lush, it's full of flavor, it's delicious and it's smooth and it's fantastic. The reason why I have you here is actually to talk about a couple of the other wines you have, but more importantly, one of my most favorite things I talk about with the audience is find your passion. Mm-hmm. And so what is your passion about wine? What makes Fontes and Phillips passionate about wine and in general?
Well, I got passionate about wine when I was 17, which is my first year in the wine business. It sounds funny not being, 21, but I worked there as a chemist, and it was just more and more intriguing. And I wasn't destined initially to be a winemaker. I was studying animal husbandry and then chemistry. So it was like, boy, that's all over the place.
Yeah.
But I found this really interesting thing called wine. And as it progressed, I worked in Napa Valley for 4 years, 5 years, till I got out of college. And that was it, I was hooked. And then it was just a matter of finding which part about it was the passion. And I found out that through my tastings and through exposure and study, that I really had three passions. Two of which came out immediately, which were sparkling wine, champagne.
Champagne, exactly. Right. We'll talk about this in a minute.
And then Pinot Noir, which is something that in the whole world, there are very few places that do it well. And so it was hard to find that right place. And that became a passion, as it has for so many winemakers, is finding that right place to get the grape growing well and to be able to produce a great wine. There's a handful. You think of Burgundy initially, you think of the Carneros district of Napa, you think of Russian River, you think of course of Santa Barbara, and so that's sort of what ended up bringing me down here eventually. And then in the early 90s, I took a very ill-fated sailing trip in the south of France, and I became very enamored with rosé.
Exactly.
And so, just the Panky rosé, it's very traditional, and so I became passionate about those because I liked them. And I thought, if I can do this well, I know there's people out there that are just like me.
Absolutely.
They're going to love these wines. And, we do them very traditionally. We don't step outside the box and do any of the high-tech stuff. They're very handmade wines.
Yep.
All the blends, which Panky is a blend, are very traditional. It's south of France, Cinsault, Grenache, and Syrah, which is the principal grapes that they use there. So we thought, well, let's do it that way. They've been doing it for hundreds of years, so I guess I don't have to rethink that one. And same thing with sparkling wine. It's initially a base wine of Grenache Blanc, and then we use the little bit of the Panky as the dosage.
Which is something that I got introduced from your wife, who is also part of the Fontes and Phillips here.
As we say, the better half.
Yeah, exactly. Is that she turned us on to mixing the two and having them together, how well they went together, and that was amazing. And from what I understand, maybe through the grapevine, I hear some of the new stuff actually has a little bit more into it, so we'll be looking forward to seeing more of the blends of the two.
Exactly. We're going to make the base wine Panky. So what we're going to do is we're going to pick the grapes a little earlier and use that because the base wine for champagne has to be lower in alcohol. So we have to pick the grapes a little earlier.
Gotcha.
But it's going to be the same blend, classic blend. So we're pretty excited about it. Right now it's in bottle. It's sitting aging, so we don't, it's hard to tell how it's going to turn out. But I have a pretty good idea it's going to be a good one.
Well, that's fantastic. Well, thank you for letting us come in and taste today. We look forward to seeing the new stuff as well as everybody getting out there and getting your hands on a bottle or two or three or maybe a case. But whatever it is out there that you get excited about, make sure you find your passion.